Extra pulmonary tuberculosis in children is a big challenge to diagnose. One of the commonest sites involved is lymph node. So what we are going to learn in this clip is how to take aspirates from lymph nodes or similar subcutaneous swellings and subject them to microbiological tests like cartridge-based nucleic acid amplification tests.
To begin with, explain the procedure and take consent from the parent or guardian. Instruments required for the procedure are sterile gloves for cleaning, alcohol pads or spirit, povidone iodine and sterile gauze are required. For aspiration, 10 to 20 ml syringes, 21 to 23 gauge needles and sterile container are needed. Cotton and adhesive tape to clean and dress the aspirate site. If quantity of aspirate is small, saline will be required to ensure that specimen doesn't dry out. Place the patient in a supine position and restrain using the long folded sheets. One end of a folded sheet is pulled over the back of the child, looping through both the arms as shown. The other end is then rolled over the arms and wrapped around the child, moving from back to the front and then to the back. The lower end of the sheet should be reaching the wrist of the patient for effective restraint. The sheet should be rolled tightly to block the movement of forearms. Disinfect the skin at the planned needle puncture site. Firstly, with alcohol 70%, followed by povidone iodine and again alcohol 70%. Between each application, let the area dry. The swelling or lymph node should be immobilized in between the fingers of one hand. Pass the needle through the skin, avoiding any superficial veins. Direct the needle towards the center of the target. Precautions must be taken to ensure that the needle tip is not pointing towards the operator's fingers, immobilizing the lymph node or deep structures below the node. Once in the target, the needle tip is moved within the target while applying suction using 10 or 20 ml syringe. Prior to withdrawal of the needle from the swelling, negative pressure must be released. Remove the needle from the swelling by pulling straight out so as not to lacerate the skin. Remove as much aspirate as possible from the swelling. Aspirate may be taken from multiple swellings and pooled before sending to laboratory for bacteriological confirmation. At the end of the procedure, dress the site after applying antiseptic. Send the aspirated collection to laboratory for further processing. If the aspirate is too small for transferring to container, then one may collect the material after aspirating and rinsing the syringe using minimal sterile normal saline. Avoid excess dilution with saline as it can lead to false negative result. A 50 ml conical tube is another type of container which can be used for sample transport instead of the disposable container shown in the video. As conical tube can be put directly into centrifuge machine, it is preferred when the sample is to be subjected to mycobacterial culture and drug sensitivity. This is also the preferred container for samples being sent to national TB program labs, as it does away the need to transfer the specimen from one container to another.